Glamdring. The foe hammer, sword of the King of Gondolin. His swords were made.
Ha ha.
Yeah.
Ha. Glamdring. Hey guys, welcome back to Nat One Videos. This is going to be a short video and there's no crafting involved. I hope you don't mind. But I realise that quite a lot of people who watch my videos, like Middle Earth and I watched a video from Adam Savage today on his YouTube channel all about Glamdring.
I'm holding Glamdring. I'm just having a moment.
Which happens to be one of my prized possessions. Yes! It's actually quite sharp. I just wanted to show you my cool sword, Glamdring. I'd really like to build a cabinet for this at some point. I'm thinking a cabinet with lights all around, maybe a purple felt background, something like that. But this video, I'm just showing you Glamdring. And that's all it is. So I hope you enjoy seeing my nice shiny sword, which is one of my favorite things in the whole entire world. I just chopped my terrain. It's not gonna be a long video, guys. So there are a few things that I own that I love quite as much as Glamdring. This is one of the first things my wife bought me almost 20 years ago that made me realize she was a keeper. And I also decided that my wife was a keeper too.
Fine.
Glamdring spans all the way back to the first age of Middle-earth. Forged by the elves for its first owner Turgon, second son of the great Fingolfin, the renowned king of the elves, who in an impassioned rage faced down the Dark Lord Morgoth and even cast fear into his heart, but alas fell to Morgoth in his last stand. Anyway, this isn't about Fingolfin, it's about Turgon and Glamdring. Turgon was the great king of Gondolin and high king of the Noldor, and is said to have wielded Glamdring in the Battle of Unnumbered Tears, also known as Nirnaeth or Nodiad. And subsequently, the sword was also wielded by Turgon in battle during the fall of Gondolin. Glamdring bore an engraving, its own name in Elvish, and if you know anything about Middle-earth, it is that if a sword has a name, it's totally badass. Also known as Foehammer, so named by the orcs who feared the sword and anyone who wielded it. Perhaps because the sword glowed blue anytime the orcs drew near, just like the famous letter opener Sting, giving the bearer the upper hand for combat that might ensue. Clearly, if you have been given a little heads up that your enemy is about to throw down, you might just have a chance to get your fighting stance ready, and if you have some skill with a blade, well...
I know that sword! It is called Glamdring! The Foehammer! No!
Glamdring was lost to history for a time, a very long time in fact, 6,000 years, and by chance or the sheer will of the blade, it found its way into the hands of one of the Ishtari, Gandalf the Grey, in the most unlikely of places, a troll cave. It's completely unknown how the blade ended up in the cave of a troll. I don't know about you, but to me there seems to be a little bit of divine intervention happening there. Arguably, it is Gandalf that truly made Glamdring a famous blade. Facing down foes such as slaying the Balrog on Durin's Tower on the peak of Zarak-Sagil above the Mines of Moria. Now this is a very brief overview of this badass sword, and to be honest, it's just an excuse for me to show you one of the coolest things that I own. But having said that, I am working on a very cool project, and the central protagonist in this story is in fact Gandalf wielding Glamdring in an epic duel. Let me know in the comments below if you think you know what I'm building. The project is coming along nicely and will be out very soon.
What are you doing, Daddy?
I'm being stupid with my sword.
Also, I am looking for a really cool way to display this sword. So if you've got any cool ideas, please let me know in the comments below. I'm thinking a cabinet with a nice glass front or plexiglass, some lighting maybe. but maybe it would suit, maybe just like a carved wooden thing. There's me hitting my terrain again. Yeah, so let me know in the comments below. I hope you like the sword, guys, and there is more videos coming soon. They're all crafting. They're just taking time to make. Anyway, have a good weekend, guys. I will see you all soon. Yeah. I did consider making an outro to this video where I cut a watermelon in half with Glamdring, but to be honest, I didn't want to risk bending the sword, so instead I ran around waving it like an idiot in my back garden. I just want to say a huge thanks to my Patreon members for their patience as I'm working on the next few projects. You guys have seen some of the progress pics and I'm really encouraged by all of your positive feedback. Can't wait to finish them up and get the videos out on YouTube. Thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a comment, subscribe, and check out my Middle Earth playlist. And if you're feeling fancy, come over and check out my Patreon. So until next we meet, Nalloway, go Vanadvin.